welcome back to the session. So in the previous session, we have seen about the other agile model, different other methods of the agile process. So let us go for the next topic, that is the core principles. What are the core principles in order to develop a software project? What are those? Let us go there. So who invented these, who proposed these core principles is by David Hooker. So he is one of the contributor of the software engineering. So he proposed the five principles for the core principles as a software development process. So what are those core principles? Let us go. So David Hooker has proposed seven core principles. So it's of seven principles that focus on software engineering practice as a whole. They are reproduced the below. So we said that software engineering is nothing but it is a process which has to be proceeded in a disciplined and quantifiable manner. That means whatever the steps we are following, it has to get some plan, it has to get some analysis, it has to get some design. So that means it has to go in a some engineering structure. So why going that engineering structure? So there are seven principles proposed by the David Hooker. So what are those seven principles? Let us see. The first principle. The reason it all exists. So the first principle is the reason it all exists. So what is the reason it all exists? So the meaning of the first principle is, so why the product is existing in the world. So we are getting the so many of the laptops or different versions of the Windows operating systems. Why we are getting the existence of those product? What is the use of the product? What is the reason for the product existence? So what is the different analysis we are doing for the existence of that product? So why developing of a software product, the first principle we have to remember is the reason it all exists. What is the reason it is existing? So why preparing of the software product? Is the product what we are preparing, is it useful for the, what are the requirements needed by the user or not? If yes, we have to proceed to the requirements, or else we have to stop it. So that is the reason it all exists. For example, now you are getting the so many of the laptops of different versions. Why we are getting the laptops of different versions of different hardware components combination? Why we are getting? So because of our simplicity, because of our usage. So some people will carry out the daily they have to carry the laptop. So if you have the laptop of huge size and huge weight, so it is very hard to the customer to, I mean user, the end user. The end user means we. So you are coming to the college. If you are bringing the laptop every day to the college, so the laptop is of a very huge one and a huge weight. That means it is of some thickness. Okay. So what you feel? So first 5 days, okay, you will carry the laptop. So after that, you will feel that, so this is very hard to get the laptop to the college from the home. So you feel if the laptop is lightweight, then it will be easy to me to carry out. So like that, you think will be different. So whatever the things there are, that means there is a reason for that. So in order to carry the laptop everywhere or anywhere, so the weight of the laptop should be a small, I mean that means less one. So there is a reason. So if it is a less weight, the everyone will carry out, or everyone will adopt to buy the laptop of that such a model. So that means there is some reason for that. So like that, for every each software product what you are developing, software system what you are developing, it must have some reason in order to exist. So that is the first principle. Coming to the second principle, keep it simple, stupid. So it is called as a KISS. So the second principle is a keep it simple or else you are stupid. That means, so whatever the product you are developing, it should be in an easy way. It should be very user friendly. It should be has to understand by the user whoever are working with that. So if you have a software, let us say, so you people have some software. Some software, let us say for your Android phones. So in this Android phones, I am using some software. So I designed one software in the Android for Android for Android phones. Android phones, smartphones. I designed one software. Okay. So what is this software is? Let us say some application. App, some app. So app is also one software. Yes. So in that software, so the user can check the, for example, the app is your college app, let us say. So if you want to attend the online quiz or online assignments or classes, online classes, through this app you can able to attend. So that is the app. So whatever the app I designed, so I have to keep in the market, then only everyone will use. So when I'm releasing in the market, after releasing in the market, so how to the user has to interact with that. That means how, where is the login page? So how to sign up? While sign up, what is the process? So it is asking only the mobile number, phone, and the email address, or else it is asking any debit card or credit card, whatever the things that it is asking. So where is the sign up phase? Where is the login page? So after login, so what are the home page for the user? So in that home page, what are the interactive icons? That means in the home page for online classes, click this icon. For some activities, for online business, you have to click this. So there is an online business, it has to give you some pop-up image. So you have a quiz today. So this is assignment, you have to, this will be closed by today by 5 p.m. Like that, it has to give you some messages. If there is no such messages, if there is no intimation to the user by who using the app, so then what is the use it? So the user is not aware of that product, he is not getting awareness. So how to it, he had to interact, he has to interact with that. So he doesn't know how to get login or how to get sign up or how to get where his quizzes are uploading, where his assignments are uploading, where his online classes are going. He doesn't know while interacting with the app. That means he is not getting able to understand what the app is. So then what is the use of I developing the app? There is no use. So in your Android Google Play Store, you have the different apps of different companies. So for Google Pay, Phone Pay, Paytm. So different apps are there for which is incorporated with the bank accounts. You can you can just connect your bank accounts over there, and with UPI based some transactions you can do. So if the transactions, how to do, where to do, why to do, so that is unknown to the user. So what is the use of implementation such apps? So there is a Google Pay. So example, Google Pay. In Google Pay, so if you search for by his name, so you will get the some phone number. So you just give the money, you just add the money. What do you want to give to that person? In such situations, if the person while interacting with that app, he is not getting where to do and how to do. So he is getting some confusion using that app. So then what is the use of that app? So what the people will say? So this is a useless app. So don't use this app. This is just confusing. There is just a confusion while doing the actions, transactions or anything else. So whatever the money we are transaction doing, that is not going to the correct person. So like that, if you get some errors, so then what is the use of the app? So whatever the things you are developing, whether it is an application or software or website, it should be in a clear manner, it should be in a simple. So while you're seeing that, so by visualization, the design, it should be a simple one. Whatever the icons you are placing, whatever the menus you are placing, it should be understandable to the user. So that is the second principle. Okay, so first principle is the reason it all exists. Second principle is keep it simple, stupid. And next, third principle. So the third principle is maintain the vision. So while developing of the software product, you have to make some vision. So vision is nothing but So you people are studying of the B.Tech. So why you people choose the B.Tech apart from the so many of the courses? You have the B.Arc, you have the, some hotel management, you have some degrees. Apart from all those, why you choose the B.Tech? Because you people have some vision, or you yourself or your parents, I don't know, whatever it is. So the student who are reading, who are studying the course, particular course, they have some vision. So okay, in future I want to move to this side. So in future I want to step in into this section. So I have to get this certificate, then only I can able to go. So that means you have some vision, clear vision of about your future, like that. So whatever the software we are developing, we should have some vision about that product. So what is this product is going to use? So after some years, so today's the software is maybe hardly working for in months only. So in few months you are getting some new technology, you are getting some new advancements in the technology, in the knowledge what they are acquiring. So if you are getting the new technologies and new knowledge, what are the software you are developing? So that becomes something obsolete. Obsolete is nothing but which has to be get some waste. Waste is nothing but like obsolete means it doesn't die, it will exist but it will not use. So according to that technology, you have to incorporate that software, existing software, then only it will use. Yes or no? For example, so yeah, operating systems. You have the operating systems, different operating systems you have. So now you are using the Windows operating system 7, let us say 7th version you people are using Windows. Okay, so you want to download some software. Let us say that software is a some Chrome of latest version. Latest version. So let the Chrome latest version is let it be some 10th version. So I want to download the Chrome of latest version 10th. So in my Windows operating system of version 7. So why means? So I have some work in Chrome operating Chrome because there is some Adobe. In order to play some videos, you have to require some Adobe Flash layer, which is getting in the latest versions. In previous versions, it is not there. So that's why in order to view some videos in the Chrome itself, in the website, so I want to use the Chrome of latest version. So in order to get the latest version of the Chrome, so my Windows operating 7, it's not cooperate because this is the Windows version of the lower version. This is the Chrome of a higher version. So in lower version, higher version will not work. So then I what have to do? So my laptop has to change. I have to integrate my laptop with the operating system of the Windows 10th version. So if my laptop capacity, storage capacity are less, then the Windows operating system I can't able to install into it. So if my laptop is a capacity, I mean storage, memory space is more, that the hard disk and RAM is the size of more, then I can able to install my operating system of I can integrate my operating system to the Windows 10. I can disable this Windows version, uninstall this Windows 7th version, I can install the Windows 10th version. That means, so if the laptop what they are designed, if the laptop is, if they keep the vision in that mind, so while developing of the laptop, so if it has to integrate according to the versions, as the versions are changed, it can integrate into itself, then the laptop will work for more. So if the laptop is not worked for the latest versions, then who what the people will do? They just simply sell out. That means given to the some companies and take a new one. Just exchange. Like that, whatever the product we are developing, whatever the software. So simple example is your Android phones. So if the phone is getting the, you are getting some, for example, you are using the 2GB. So we are getting the now 4GB and 6GB phones. So whatever the apps you are installing that is not supporting by your phone, what you people do? You just sold out and you will get the new version of the mobiles. Like that, whatever the software we are developing, we have to keep in vision. So, what is in future, if there is any technology advancements, is that system what we are developing, is it adaptable to that or not? So, we have to take care of that. So, that is the third principle. And the fourth principle, what you produce, others will consume. So, whatever the things, whatever the softwares you are developing, whatever the systems you are developing, it will be consumed by others. Yes, it will be consumed because you are developing your software product. What, for what purpose you are developing? For the utilization. Who can utilize? The others, the people, the users. So you have the smart board. Who utilizing the smart board? So we are utilizing the smart board for what? For online classes. So the smart board is invented by some people. So but it is using by the others. So that is the fourth principle. And fifth principle, be open to the future. So be open to the future is nothing but, future means the coming generation. So coming generation, you will get the so many of the technology advancements and the knowledge as well as the usage of the products. Okay, in previous days, there is no smartphones. You have to use only the some GSM mobiles. Now we are using the smartphones. Everyone is using the smartphones in the world. So that means we are advancing in the future. So what is the future? So if the product, whatever the product you are using, this is the principle is same as the maintain the vision. So according to the vision. Okay. So we have to, whatever the system we are developing, it has to adopt the new technologies, whatever is coming in the future. So that is a be open to the future. And the sixth principle is plan ahead for new reuse. So whatever the product you are developing, it should be a reusable one. So like your laptops. So whatever the operating system you are installing, it is working. If it not work, then you will be get it out and you will get the some new thing. So like that, whatever the products you are using, so it should be a reusable one. That means it has to adapt to the new software, whatever it is getting into it. So your laptop is support to the 7th version, 8th version and 10th version. That means it is getting adapted to the new versions. That means it is reusing. We are reusing it. If you, there is no option for the reuse for the software product. So whatever the products you are developing. So after the some technology advancements. So the product is not reusable one. What you will do? Just you will throw out. So if you throw out, what is the meaning of that? That means what is the time invested into that? What is the work they invested? What is the cost they invested? Everything will be gone. So developing of a software is not an easy thing. So it has to invest more and more money in order to get the some software product into the world. Okay. So that is the plan ahead for reuse. So whatever the technology advancements are there, the product we have to reuse. And seventh principle, the last principle is think. The most important one is think. So what is the customer or stakeholder requirements? According to that requirements, what we have to do? So after doing what the product has to give, so what is going on? So what is the thing we have to develop? So is the thing is useful to the world or not? Is the thing what we are developing is useful for others or not? So everything we have to consider. So that is the thing. So whatever the step you are taking in the software engineering, whether in the requirement analysis or whether in the designing part, whether in the implementation part, whatever the step you are taking, you have to think first. So if you write the code in these lines, what will happen? So if you write the code in this type, what will happen? So like that, you have to think. So that is the thing. So these are the seven principles for the software engineering in order to produce a software product. Okay. So these are the core principles. That means main principles. And next one is principles that guide each framework activity. So So what is the framework activity? In the first unit we have seen the framework activities. So in the process we have the 7 set of framework activities. What are those framework activities? Requirements, framework activities, first one is requirements, second one analysis, implementation, and coding. So implementation is coding and deployment. Last is deployment. So planning, requirements, analysis. So these are the framework activities. So in order to perform these framework activities, there is some guidelines, there are some principles. In order to follow this, we have to construct in the framework activities in a systematic manner. So what are those principles? Let us see. So first one is a principle one. So what is a principle one? Customer expectations for the software must be managed. So customer expectations. So why we are when we are developing the software product, it is as per the customer requirements. So what are the requirements given by the customer? The developer has to come to know what is each and every step clearly. So what the customer will think, for example, let us say this is a smart marker, I mean smart board pen. So in this pen I wanted two buttons. So one button has to work like eraser. So in the previous sessions what I was the same example. So one button has to work as a smart board eraser. So I don't want to go over the menu and how I don't want to select the item, I mean option over there. So I have to get up two buttons over here. One is for color changing, one is for the eraser. So that is my requirements. So after telling to the customer, I mean the developer, what I think, okay, I will get the pen like this only with the two buttons as the options for that. So I think that is my expectations. But actually what the product is, so but actually the developer has to give the clear picture what it is. So in what way we are developing that product. So in what way your product will be. At the end of that product, how it looks. So everything we have to be clear to the customer. So the customer expectations for the software must be managed. We have to manage all those expectations. So for this expectations, there is a book given by the 9 Naomi Kent. So Naomi Kent is one of the contributor. She wrote the one book on management expectations. That the book's name is Management Expectations. So in that she wrote what she wrote is, so while giving the statements to the user, the customer. So it depends upon the how you are talking, what you are mentioning to the customers. So while taking the requirements, the developer has to be should be very careful what he was talking about the product, how he was delivering the product expectations. So that depends upon the developer. So he has to take care. So he has to manage the customer expectations. So what are the requirements? I said I want the two buttons. So what I think, the pen will be the same and I will get these two buttons over here. But actually what the while developing or after developing of the product, it may the size may vary, the shape may vary, the pen look different, will be different. Okay, so that these are expectations. The expectations of the customer should be managed by the developers. And next, second principle. A complete delivery package should be assembled and tested. So after developing of the software product, so after before going to deliver to the product, that means you are giving the some software, whatever the product, whether it is a website or whether it is an app or whether it is a some operating system, whatever it is, some software. So while delivering the software to the customer, so it has to be tested first. So it has to be assembled. Assembled is nothing but so the developer's environment is different from the customer environment. So customer means we are the customers. So in our, the laptop sizes may vary, hard disk may be vary with the developers, because developers means will be work on so many of the softwares. So they will have some huge environment over there, different tools to manage the software. So those tools we doesn't have. The customer will not have all those tools, because the customer doesn't need all those tools. So every software tool has to be get up by paying the money. So what the customer will maintain according to his software, so whatever he requires, that one only he will maintain because of the cost. Okay. So before delivering the product to the customer, so we have to do the software which has to be indulged in his environment, that means in his laptop, according to his hardware specifications, according to his specifications, we have to maintain the, or we have to deliver the software. So that is the hand tested. Tested means, so you have to run the software, whether it is working without any errors, whether you are getting any errors while logging or sign up. So wherever you are getting some errors, you have to check at each and every step of the software, and you have to deliver. So that is the second principle. And the third principle, a support design must be established before the software delivery. So support resume is nothing but some documentation. So while delivering in the second step process, we have to test and assemble. In the third step, what we have to do is, whatever the software we are delivering to the customer, so we have to maintain some documentation regarding that. That means, what are the things we involved in that? So what is the software requirements for that? What are the hardware requirements for that? What are the design implementation we have did? So what is the code we did? So everything should be noted in a one document book. So that book has to be given. And next, fourth principle is, appropriate instructional materials must be provided to the end users. So when you are buying some phones, you are getting some manual, or a TV or fridge, whatever the things you are buying, electronic goods, you will get some manual. What is that manual? So they will give you some directions. So from this side you can remove the battery, from this side you have to insert your SIM or memory card, whatever you are. So some instructions they will give. So why the instructions are giving? Because while using the product, you have to take care of the product. If you misuse, then the product will not work properly. Then who can blame that? The user will blame the product developer. That's why they will issue some instructional manuals. And principle 5, a complete delivery package should be assembled and tested. So same. And principle 6, buggy software should be fixed first and delivered later. So buggy software is, buggy is nothing but error. So while interacting with the software, if you get any error, so if you're getting any pop-up messages wrongly, then you have to fix that one. That means you have to you have to fix the errors. That means you have to remove these errors. So in software error, we call this in scientific word bug. Okay. So these are the 6 principles you have to guide for the framework attitude. Okay. So summary. So first we have seen about the 7 core principles given by the David Hooker. And next we have seen the 6 principles for to guide the framework activities. So core principles are the 7 principles, and framework activity principle guides are the 6. Count is 6, this is the count is 7. So this is for today's session. Thank you.